We've got to be quiet because we're going to surprise Oscar. It's his 5th birthday. Come on. Okay, everybody ready?
Yeah.
Good. Oscar?
Go away.
Hey, Oscar, come on out for a minute. Come on, Oscar.
Surprise!
Oscar!
Oscar! Come on, Oscar! Come on, Oscar! Oscar, don't you know what day today is?
No, I don't know, and I don't care.
Oh, come on.
Come on, Oscar.
Why don't you all go away and let me sleep?
Oh. Hey, Oscar, look, doesn't this mean anything to you?
Only that you should wash your hand.
No, Oscar, five.
Goodbye, please.
Come on, Oscar, five. Doesn't five mean anything to you? Five.
Never heard of it. What's a five?
Yeah.
Maybe that's the problem. He doesn't know what five is, huh? Uh-huh. Well, we can fix that. Oscar, watch.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. One, two, three, four.
Five fingers.
One, two, three, four, five.
Five ice cream sodas.
One, two, three, four, five.
Five. Whatever they are.
One, two, three, four, five.
Five frogs.
One, two, three, four, five.
Five guys.
One, two, three, four, five.
Five fancy fruitcakes.
Okay, Oscar, now what do you think?
That you should all go away and leave me to the peace of my trash can.
Oh, come on, Oscar.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Oscar. Happy birthday to you.
Well, if you're all through with your silly song, why don't you all scram?
Well, first you have to blow out the candles.
Why? Why do I have to blow out the candles?
Because it's for good luck. But first, make a wish.
Make a wish? Well, all right. I wish that all these people would go away.
Come on, let's blow out the candles.
Yes, blow out the candles. Blow them out, Oscar.
All right.
Now,
will you make my wish come true?
Happy birthday, Oscar. Grow 100 years.
Why doesn't everybody just leave me alone? Fifth birthday, eh? I wonder if Mother will call. Thank you. Look, Look at that. Wait. The wax has melted all over my cake. Oh, boy.
One, two, three, four.
Was a hand. Like most hands, it had a thumb and four fingers. 1, 2, 3, 4. Which all got along quite well together. And like most hands, it was quite limber and useful. This particular hand, though, for some reason felt especially proud of all the clever things he could do. For instance, he could wave hello. And he could wave goodbye. He could tell someone to come ahead. Or to stop. He could say when things were okay. And he could point to exactly what he wanted. He was also quite pleased that he could be so strong. Or gentle. Or scary, and that he could stand at attention so well. He could also scratch just about anywhere he itched. But one thing bothered the proud hand who could do so many things. He could not for the life of him make a noise. He had tried many times without success. And once, when the hand was thinking about this very thing, the little finger told the others about a way he had seen another hand make a noise. So they tried that, too. But somehow, it wasn't really what they were after. Although he knew it was silly, the hand became quite dejected. Then something happened. Which only goes to show, there's really no way around it. It takes two hands to clap.
Susan's in there so busy that I decided I was going to fold these blankets myself. Now, get the corners together, fold them neatly. That's the way she wants it. That's the way we'll do it. All right, blanket. You are going to get folded. It's going to be you or me. Got it? There. No, that's no good.
Well, it's not the best job of blanket folding I've ever seen.
Yeah, well, I guess it's a job that takes two people.
Why didn't you call me to help you?
Well, you were busy in there, so I figured I'd do it myself.
Well, there are some jobs that just take two people to do them.
Yeah, any two people except Buddy and Jim.
Oh, well, Buddy and Jim.
Hiya, Jim.
Oh, hello, Buddy.
What you doing?
I'm just reading the newspaper. You know, it's a little dark in here. Would you put the light on, please?
Sure.
Yeah.
Jim, I think the bulb blew out.
I know the bulb blew out. I can see that. Well, don't just stand there. Get a new bulb. What are you doing with a light bulb in your pocket?
If you put it in your shoes, they break. Hey, Jim. You want me to put the light bulb in for you?
Oh, no, you just mess it up. I'll do it myself.
I'd probably mess it up.
You'd
probably
mess it up. Uh-oh. This is too high. I can't reach it.
What are we going to do?
You see that big box over there? You bring that big box over here. See? Huh? I'll stand on top of the box, then I'll be able to reach the light.
That's good, Jim. I put the big box over here under the light, and you're going to stand on top of it, then you can reach it.
And I'll be able to reach the light.
Oh, something's wrong here.
Wow, that's high, Jim. You know, if you can't reach it, it's high. I never saw anything you couldn't reach.
I got it. You see that other box over there?
Yeah.
Bring that box over here. Put that box on top of this box. I'll stand on two boxes. Then I'll be able to reach the light.
That's smart, Jim.
Yeah.
Because if I bring that box over here and put it on top of the big box, and then Jim stands on top of both boxes, boy, you can reach that light bulb,
sure,
aren't you?
Yeah.
Go get him, Jim.
Okay. Bring the box over here.
Yeah, okay. Okay, Jim. The little box on top of the big box, and then Jim going to
stand on both the boxes,
two boxes,
and then it'd be so easy to reach.
Go get him, Jim!
Boy, that's higher than I thought it
that's
was.
That's a high light bulb.
I don't understand that. I bought the big box over here. Put the other box on top of the big box.
Hey, Jim. Jim. Do you know why you can't reach that light bulb?
Why?
The tops of your boxes are broken.
No, they're not broken.
Jim, they're broken. Get off and I'll show you. The tops of your boxes are broken. Look at here, Jim. Look. See? The tops of the boxes are gone.
What do you call that?
That is the top of the box.
Does that look broken to you?
No, that's not broken, Jim.
Well, then what are you bothering me for? I have to unscrew out this old bulb. And I have to get a real good grip on it. Okay? Now, Buddy, you pick me up and turn me around.
Oh, okay, Jim.
Okay?
Yep.
You ready?
Yep.
Go. All right, turn me around.
Okay.
Okay, the bulb's out.
The bulb's out?
Yeah. Wow. Take the old one out, and we'll put in the new one.
That's a real good, Jim.
And when I get it into place, you pick me up and turn me around.
Okay.
Go. No, the other way.
Oh, okay,
Jim. Gotta screw it in.
How you doing, Jim?
All right, one more time.
One more?
There, we got it.
Hey.
Now, I got a new bulb.
Well, that's a new light bulb.
That sure is. I told you I'd fix it.
Jim?
What?
You know something?
What?
I think you could do most anything you want to do.
You know something?
Yeah.
I think you're right. Okay. Now, I'm going to go back to reading my newspaper.
Yeah?
I want you to put the light on.
You're going to read the paper?
Sure.
And old Buddy's going to put the light on for Jimmy.
Right.
Hey, Jim. I think the light bulb blew out.
I know the light bulb blew out. I can see that. But don't just stand there. Get a new bulb. What are you doing with a light bulb in your pocket?
If you put them in your shoes, they break. Hey, Jim. Want me to change the light bulb for you?
No, you probably mess it up. I'll just do it myself.
I'd mess it up, but you can do it, Jim.
I can do it.
You can do most...
Do you like day or nighttime best, Gregory?
Night.
Do you like the night? Why?
Because every time you go to sleep, it's get morning all the time.
And well, at least it's going to be morning. What time do you like best, Jackie?
Day.
Day? How come?
Go to school.
You get to go to school, atta girl. I like the night best. I'm like Gregory. I'm going to read you a story about the night and what happens at night. You know what? At night, when most children are asleep, many things are different. Smells and sounds are more important, and black is the main color. Darkness is all around like the air. All little sounds are big, and in the quiet street, people talk more softly. It's night over half the world. Did you know when it's night in here that someplace else in the world it's daytime? And when it's daytime there, someplace else in the world, it's night? Yeah. In the house, the empty hall waits for the day. The grown-ups talk, or read, or look out at the stars, or sleep. In your room, the only sound is breathing. That tells Mother that you're really sleeping sound, right? Outside, the air smells secret, and the leaves in the trees rustle without being seen, and no birds sing. Who knows the only bird that stays up all night long?
Owl.
An owl, yeah. That's why
And the chicken, too.
The chicken just gets up early. He's the first one up, but the owl stays up all night.
Oh.
And that's why if you don't want to sleep, your mother would call you a night owl.
The owl wake you up.
The garden is only a dark smell in the dark. Just beyond the fence around the field, the world ends. High up, the moon races through the clouds. See the moon? You can't see it until it comes out in the clear, though.
See, there it is.
Yeah, there it is.
It's gonna come out and be there.
Stopping when it reaches clear sky. There it is, see?
See, when it's be there, it's be morning.
No, that's the moon. That's when the sun comes out, it's morning.
When the moon comes here, this means it's me morning.
No, the sun means morning. The roof across the street is darker than the sky. See? Have you got a window in your bedroom to look out and see the buildings?
Yeah.
Yeah, the ones across the street always look darker.
I got a next door neighbor.
Oh, that's good. So do we. Street lamps drop pale light all up and down the block. And a gray cat turns orange in the light. See the kitty?
I had a cat.
You did?
And I found it. My mama didn't let me keep it, so it ran away in our hallway, and I thought it was a dog.
Oh, okay, let's go on. In the summer, the ice cream truck comes by late, and its silver bells are silvery in the night.
Ding!
That's right. The sidewalk surprises people's feet with ups and downs, not there in the daylight, because you can't really see as well, right? The traffic light stands in the empty street, blinking red, green, red, green, all the night long.
The street, when
poor old traffic light stands out there all night, whether there's anybody or not. What's
when the... when you say green, red, what happens?
No.
Looks like the TV You know that.
Never mind. Come on. The school gates are closed. See? Everybody's gone home. And in all the rooms, there's nobody. It's all the children at home in bed.
Hey,
at the window. Just a minute, Gregory. Now listen. At the window, only a paper fish looks out. See the fish looking out at us? See the fish looking out at us? Look at the book.
That's a real fish?
No, it's a paper fish they made in class. In the empty playground, the wind tries out a swing or two, just a little. The candy store is locked, and the pearly light high in the ceiling makes big shadows. Are you looking at the pictures in the book, Gregory? See? Look. Far off, a dog barks. Bark like a dog. Importantly, nothing important. That's right. And on the river, a boat whistles and counts to three and stops. Whistle like the boat. That's no boat whistle. Next door, a telephone rings and rings and ring. Oh, somebody picked it up.
Ding.
That's not a telephone ring. That's a doorbell. The night over half the world. It's night over half the world, but soon it will be day. See, it's beginning to be daylight. See, because the sun's coming up. So that was at night, and there's our title. Now, who knows what words are made of, Jackie? You know what words are made up of? Letters, right? What is this letter right here, Jackie?
A.
A, and that's the beginning of our alphabet, right?
A.
How many of the letters can you say, Gregory? Start out, and Jackie will help you, and I'll help Jackie, and you'll both help me, okay? Start out. Yeah.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, K, J.
Oh, there. J,
K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z.
Oh, that's pretty good. I think that at least deserves a cookie. What do you think? You think that deserves a cookie?
Lunch.
That deserves lunch. Oh, no. You're not good enough for lunch yet, but you'll get a cookie. How about that, Jen?
While fishing for dinner one day, a boy caught a big letter A. He then caught a B, a C, D, and E, and an F, G, H, I, J, and K. Unhappy, the boy sat and thought,
I can't eat these letters I caught. I must catch some fish to fill up my dish, or my whole afternoon is for naught.
But as soon as his hook hit the sea, he caught L, M, N, O, and P. And Q, R, S, T, and a U, and a V, and a W, X, Y, and Z. Now hungry, he stared at the group. Then suddenly, grabbing a scoop, he had a bright notion, and cooked up a potion, and feasted on alphabet soup.
Oh, I'm sorry. This is the capital letter A. Next to it is the small letter A. Many words begin with this letter. Alligator, for instance. An alligator is an American reptile, similar to the crocodile, but having a shorter and flatter head.
They have also been known to be extremely dangerous.
Above my head is the letter B. It is the first letter in the word boxer. These are boxing gloves. Boxers wear them for protection. Ooh! Of course, the boxer's gloves aren't much help if his opponent doesn't hit him in the hands.
A. 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 A.
Dumb.
Hey, Ernie. Hey, Ernie, what's the matter?
What's the matter?
Yeah.
Look at the dumb TV. It's been going A like that for 4 days. It's on all the channels. It's driving me absolutely bananas.
Well, look, now, maybe we can fix it now. I'll turn off the set, and you go back there and see if anything's wrong, okay?
Okay.
Hey. What?
I found an acorn back there.
An acorn?
Yeah. Looky here. Here's a can of apricots. How about that?
A can of apricots.
Yeah. Oh!
What?
Here's an apron.
An apron.
Yeah, see that?
It's a nice fit.
Yeah. Okay. Ooh! There's an ape.
An ape?
Yes, an ape. Oh, looky here.
Looky where?
There's an A.
An A? Well, now there's your trouble. You see, you had all those A things in there. Mm. Now, come on back here, and I'll turn on the set and see if anything's, if it's gotten better, okay?
Okay.
Okay.
B.
Hmm.
B.
Oh, look.
B.
I'm sorry, Ernie.
B.
I thought that I fixed it, you know.
B.
Oh, excuse me, Bert. Thank you for fixing the set.
B.
Fixing the set. It's just like it was before, except it's a letter B now instead of the letter A.
Isn't that beautiful?
B. B. B.
Not bad.
B. B.
La 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 la. B. Butterfly. B. A. Ape. Ape? A.
Wait till you see this. Mauricio, you ready to show them what you can do? Go ahead.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z.
Wasn't that terrific? Non-stop, you did it perfect. You're great. You happy?
Yeah.
You are? You know, happiness is knowing all the letters of the alphabet, a lollipop, and a lot of other things.
Happiness is two kinds of ice cream.
Finding your escape key.
And telling the time.
Oh, happiness is learning to whistle.
And tying your shoe for the very first time.
And happiness is playing the drum in your own school band.
And, happiness is walking hand in hand.
You know, happiness is five different crayons.
Knowing a secret.
Climbing a tree.
Happiness is finding a nickel.
Catching a firefly, setting him free.
And happiness is being alone every now and then. Happiness is morning and evening, daytime and nighttime too. For happiness is anyone and anything at all that's
this is an X. Even upside down, it's still an X. many words begin with X, such as, of course, we, X begins, did I show you when you, yeah, I showed you that. All right, X is a very important letter. Many words end with X, such as,
I came running around that kind of phone.
Pardon me? Fox. Box. Ox. Fix. Axe. One more X I should mention. Exit. Goodbye.
Mm-hmm.
Hi there, Bert. Hey, Bert.
Yeah?
You know, I was just thinking about the alphabet you got in there, you know?
Mm.
It's really pretty terrific, you know?
Yeah, it's okay.
Yeah. Do you have a favorite letter, Bert?
A favorite letter?
Mm-hmm.
That's ridiculous.
You mean there isn't one letter in that whole book that you like better than all the others? I mean, one letter you get all excited about?
No, I like them all just about the same, you know. About the same.
Yeah. Weird. No favorite letter.
Weird? That's not weird at all. I suppose you have a favorite letter, though.
Oh, listen! Ha! I sure do!
Yeah.
Oh, yeah!
What is it?
X.
X?
Yes, indeed.
X? Why X? That's a silly letter that you hardly ever use.
Oh, yes, but it's delicious.
Now, that is really ridiculous. Now, how can it possibly be delicious?
Well, you see, every morning for breakfast, I have bacon and scrambled X.
This is an X. Even upside down, it's still an X. Many words begin with X, such as, well, and of course we, X, begins, did I show you when you, yeah, I showed you that. All right, X is a very important letter. Many words end with X, such as,
I came down here and had a kind of phone.
Pardon me? Oh, yeah, Fox. Box. Ox. Fix. Axe. One more X I should mention. Exit. Goodbye.
Now, this is a square. You can tell it's a square because it has four sides all the same length. One, two, three, four. And it doesn't matter how you hold it. You can hold it this way or this way. It's still a square. Now, this is another square. It's a much smaller square, but it's still a square because it has four sides all the same length. So it doesn't really matter whether it's big like this one or small like this one, or what color it is, or anything. As long as it has four sides all the same length, it's still a square. Now, you can make a square out of cardboard or paper, or if you have four strips of cardboard like this, all the same length, you can make a square of all of your own. Now, there's one, two, three, four. That's sort of a different kind of square. This is a kind of an open square, but it still has four sides, one, two, three, four, all the same length. This is a solid square. Now that you know all about squares, right, we'll see, because I've got a picture here, and in this picture, there's a square. But it's hidden, so you can't really see it too easily. And the trick is, you find it before I finish singing my song. Now look very carefully. There's a square in there, but the question is, where do you think that you can find it? You must be aware of the shape of a square if you really want to find it. So stare with care as you look for the square. Did you find it? Did you find it? If not, when I snap my fingers on the count of three, you'll see the square light up. Watch now. One, two, three. There it is, right there. Funnel of the ship. One, two, three, four sides, a perfect square. I'll bet you found that one. Listen, I've got one more picture here, and let's see if you can find the square in this one. Now remember, squares don't always have to be the same size. They can be big, or they can be little. Now see if you can find this one before I finish my song. Well, there's a square in there, but the question is where? Do you think that you can find it? You must be aware of the shape of a square if you really want to find it. So stare with care as you look for the square. Did you find it? Did you find it? If not, this time, when I snap my fingers in the count of two, the square is going to light up. Ready? One, two. How about that? The old hot dog stand. One, two, three. Four sides, perfect square. Now, this is a triangle. It has three sides. One, two, three. And you already know that this is a square and it has four sides. But what you don't know is what happens when the triangle meets the square.
Once there was a very jazzy triangle who just loved to dance. As you can see, a triangle has three sides. One, two, three. One day, the triangle met a very square square, who also loved to dance in his own way.
Boy, are you square? You don't move. You're always the same. All four sides, the same length. One, two, three, four. All four corners square as a box. I have three sides, and I can make them as long or as short as I want. I can be tall and thin, or short and fat, depending on how I feel. I sure am glad I'm a triangle.
Well, it's true I can't dance as well as you can, and my sides and corners are always the same. But I don't have to decide which side to make long and which short. And I never have to think about what shape I want to be. I like being a square.
Yeah, but wouldn't you like to be able to move around as you please, like me, and change your shape any time you feel like it? Like this?
When you're a square, and that's that. Nothing personal. You like being a triangle. I like being a square. Everyone can't be the same. Well, so long. Nice talking to you. The triangle watched him go.
Not a bad guy,
he thought.
For a square.
And he danced all the way home. Thank you.
Hey, come on, Ernie. Dinner's ready.
Okay, Bert. I'll be right along. Okay. Right after I have a couple of these cookies.
Hey, no, you ding-a-ling. No, you don't eat cookies before dinner. You eat them after dinner. They might spoil your appetite.
Right, Bert.
Okay.
I'll be right along, right after I have a couple of these cookies.
Good. Hey, no, wait a minute now. Hey, Ernie. Now, don't you know the difference between before and after?
Oh, sure, Bert. Yeah, I just, well, I'm not so sure.
Yeah. Okay, well, now listen carefully, and I'll try and explain it to you, all right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now, you see, before you can have those cookies, you have to lift that cover.
Uh-huh.
Right. Now, after the cover is lifted, then you can have the cookies.
Oh, right.
Right. Now you understand?
Well, let me see now. Make sure I understand it. Now, before I can have a cookie, I have to lift the cover.
Right.
Now, after I lift the cover, then I can have a cookie. Right.
Okay, now let's go to dinner, okay?
Oh, no. I'm not sure. I'm not sure that I got it absolutely straight. Now, see if this is right.
Yeah.
Now, before I can have a cookie, I have to lift the cover.
Right.
Now, then, after I lift the cover, then I can have a cookie.
Okay, right. Now, you know it, so let's go.
One more time. One more time, just to make sure, absolutely certain I got it right.
All right.
Now, before I can have a cookie, I have to lift the cover.
The cover.
After the cover is lifted, then I can have the fourth cookie.
Right. Okay, now you understand, so let's go and eat, all right?
Eat?
Yeah.
Gee, Bert, I'm not hungry now. You want a cookie, Bert?
172, 573, 574, 575, 576, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, 577, into the jar and putting the jar on the window, and the first one who comes closest to guessing how many jelly beans there are in a jar will win a prize.
Oh.
But I have to know how many there are.
Oh, I see.
And what can I do for you?
Well, I'd like 6 rolls of 127 film.
127 film? Mm-hmm. 6 rolls?
Right.
Whoops, two, whoops. Yes, here we are. 6 rolls. That'll be
$3.60. $3. One, two, three, 60. Oh, there you are.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye bye. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
All right. You got the film?
Yeah, right here.
Good.
Ow.
Hey, Big, wait a minute. Big Bird, what's the matter with you?
Oh.
What's the matter?
That silly thing brewing there, it jumped out and tripped me.
Oh, come on. You mean this? That's not a silly thing, Big Bird. It's a fire hydrant. It's not growing there either. It's a fire hydrant. See?
Well, it was placed there to trip unsuspecting birds.
No, it wasn't. It was put there by firemen to get water from in case there's a fire.
Oh?
Yeah.
You mean if they get thirsty?
No. No, it's not that at all. They get water from this, they take the water from it, and they spray it on a fire to put the fire out.
Oh. Well, that's very clever, but how do they get all that water in that little bitty thing?
Well, look, Big Bird, the water isn't all in there. You see, this hydrant is connected to big water pipes that are buried in the street under here. And these pipes carry the water from, well, from all over.
Oh.
Yeah.
8 by 11, 8 by 12, 8 by 13.
I lost the count. Oh, geez, I'm sorry. Hey, how's your bean contest coming along anyway?
Terrible. People will leave me alone to count the jelly beans. Here's your paper. That'll be 25 cents.
Right. There you go. Thanks, Mr. Hooper.
You're welcome. Guess how many jelly beans will win a prize? It's still a good idea. I'll try once more. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
5 fingers.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
5 ice cream sodas.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5.
Whatever they are.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
5 frogs.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
5 times.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
5 fancy fruitcakes.
Hello? No. Well, what number did you want? 8484489? Well, this is not 8484489. 4489, 4489, 4490, 44. Oh no, I lost the count again. Guess how many beans and win the prize. It's still a good idea. I'll try once more. One, two, three, four.
1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 4, 4.
915, 916, 917, 918, 920, 921, 922, 923, 924, 925, 926, 927, 928, 929.
Now, what can I do for you?
4 number 2 pencils and 2 boxes of 50 paper clips each.
Oh, you see what that would have done to me? I would have lost the count for sure, but this time I wrote it down. 929. Now you know exactly how many jelly beans there are in that jar.
Hey, these are good.
What are good?
The beans in this jar. They're good.
How many did you eat?
Not very many, but I'll pay you for them. You know,
how many will you pay me for?
What?
How many did you eat?
Oh, I think 3.
3.
5. 5.
5.
Yeah. 14. Oh, come on, Mr. Hooper. I was only kidding. I didn't eat any jelly beans.
Me.
Oh, boy, you.
The number you have down here is exactly right. 929. I didn't touch a jelly.
It was a joke.
What do you want?
I want 4 number 2 pencils and those 2 boxes of paper clips here. I'll just put them right in my bag, okay?
Hey, and the 4 number 2 pencils.
There you are.
That's
good. We're just dropping right
in. Hey, we're here on Sesame Street all the time.
Thank you.
You come back and join us anytime you want to.
Oh, you had me full.
Oh, you mean for me?
Yes, for you.
Thank you.
Let's have a little party.
Have a jelly bean party.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters A, B, and X, and by the number 5. The book read on today's program was At Night, written by Philip Ressner, photographs by Charles Pratt, text copyright 1967 by Philip Ressner. Photographs copyright 1967 by Charles Pratt. Used by permission of E.P. Dutton and Company, Incorporated. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
Public Television Network.